The resident district commissioner is bothered by the fact that more residents have continued to lose property to these moneylenders. She sees borrowers are lured into signing contracts that are not clear and present property as security.
We are having moneylenders who are not registered. So these moneylenders, when they are giving money to the people, they sign agreements that they've bought land instead of using the land as security. But it is as a result because these moneylenders are not registered. So you find, and the other problem which we are finding is you find one person has sold land to five moneylenders. So when this person fails to pay, all the five run to the same piece of land. But I'm also correcting this in the meetings that I'm having with the local leaders, especially their personnel or C1s, to make sure that their people are the keen before they give people letters or before they stamp on any document.
The Fort Portal City Commercial Officer says most moneylenders have remained adamant on legalizing their business but continue to extort a lot of money from their clients on top of grabbing their property. He has called for community empowerment on financial literacy and also cautioned the public against dealing with unregistered moneylenders.
It's important that now the community, if you borrow money, make sure you inquire. Is that moneylender registered with the Microfinance Regulatory Authority? If not so, you go to a commercial bank which are giving loans that are recommended by the Bank of Uganda. Then another thing is the SACCOs. There are many SACCOs which have come up. You borrow, instead of going to those, at least you first try all these avenues. Yeah, because in a SACCO, I don't expect an agreement of selling that they have sold my security.
Hussein Kato, an economist, says that several businesses have closed stock after their owners failed to pay the high interest rates charged by moneylenders. Kato says that although moneylenders offer quick financial help to the public, their unregulated interest rates continue to affect the national economy.
To regulate the moneylenders, because people will not avoid getting money from moneylenders because they are frustrated business-wise. More especially this during COVID season, most businesses are collapsing, people have eaten up capital. So now they are trying to restore themselves by getting money from moneylenders, which is very dangerous. The moneylenders, few of them that pay tax to the government. But these businesses that are closing because of the moneylenders, they have been paying tax. Meaning the government is fully affected by moneylenders, by disorganizing the business community.
Some of the people who have been victims of moneylenders in Fort Portal shared their experience.
The challenge we are facing with moneylenders is one. Okay, there are many, but now the biggest one is when you give them something like a security. All their prayer is to take it. You call them for their money, they will not pick. But when it's not there for them picking, or it's time for them to take what you give them as a security, they'll come very fast. That
thing is,
the interest is very high.
Moneylenders think their only problem is exploitation. Because, for example, if you need 200,000, you give them, you are saying, worth 1 million, and they give you 200,000.
Willie Magezi, a businessman in Fort Portal, has, however, defended the activities of moneylenders and their mode of operations.
I am coming in as a rescue. Every time you run to a moneylender, you've dialed 911. So it is, do not look at it from an exorbitant point of view that I'm extracting money from you, but I am helping you because you are in a quick need. When you come to me, I give you my money at 20%. Abukuba kinyine security, the banker is taking money from every Tom, Harry and Dick, and their money is insured. I am giving you my savings, but there is no security. There is no insurance. So it's not about extorting, we are just giving people a helping hand.
By Roger Sunday for the news.